हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेक्शन 22 टू सेक्शन 25 ऑफ एलएलपी एक्ट 2008। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद डिस्कशन। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस सेक्शन 22 ऑफ द एलएलपी एक्ट। सेक्शन 22 टॉक्स अबाउट द एलिजिबिलिटी टू बिकम अ पार्टनर इन एलएलपी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हेन एवर द इनकॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ एलएलपी हैपन, पर्सन हु हैड सब्सक्राइब्ड देयर नेम टू द एलएलपी incorporation document shall become the partner in the LLP. Further, any other person may become the partner in the existing LLP in accordance with the condition mentioned in the LLP agreement. Further, it should be within the provision provided under the LLP Act 2008. Example, suppose AB Infra LLP is incorporated in which Mr. A and Mr. B have subscribed their name to the incorporation document, then A and B shall be the partner of the LLP. If after incorporation of LLP, a new partner Mr. Z want to become a partner, then Mr. Z can become a partner in LLP as per the LLP agreement. So, after incorporation, if any person want to become a partner in LLP, then they have to see the LLP agreement and they can enter in the LLP as a partner in accordance with the LLP agreement. Section 23 deals with the relationship of the partner in LLP. The mutual rights as well as the duty of the partner in LLP shall be governed by the LLP agreement between the partner and between LLP and its partner. If there is any change in the LLP agreement, then it shall be filed with the registrar. So, it is compulsion for LLP. If there is any change in the LLP agreement, then it is required to be filed with the registrar. Suppose, before incorporation of LLP, the partners have made the agreement and the partner want to impose such obligation which they have entered before the incorporation of LLP, then such obligation may be imposed on LLP subject to the condition that such agreement is ratified by all the partner after incorporation of LLP. So, any agreement in writing made before incorporation of LLP between the person who had subscribed their name, that is the first partner of the LLP, may impose the obligation on the LLP provided that such agreement is ratified by all the partners after the incorporation of LLP. For example, Mr. A and B had made agreement before incorporation of LLP, then any act done under the agreement may bind LLP if such agreement is ratified by all the partners, that is Mr. A and Mr. B, after the incorporation of LLP. If in any matter there is no agreement clause is mentioned in the LLP agreement, then for such matter mutual rights as well as the duty of the partner will be determined as per the provision which are set out in the first schedule. So, if there is an absence of any matter relating to the mutual rights or a duty of the partner, then it shall be determined by the provision relating to that matter as given under the first schedule of the LLP Act 2008. Next, Section 24, cessation of partnership interest. Section 24. A person may cease to become a partner of LLP in accordance with the LLP agreement with the other partner. So, person may cease to be a partner in LLP as per the agreement between the other partner, that is as per the LLP agreement. If there is absence of such matter in the LLP agreement, then person may resign from LLP after giving the notice for not less than 30 days. So, in the absence of any agreement with other partner relating to the cessation of being a partner, then partner may, by giving the notice in a writing for not less than 30 years to the other partner, he can give his intention to resign as a partner from the LLP. Example, ABC Creative LLP has three partners. Now Mr. A wants to retire from LLP. If there is no clause in the LLP agreement regarding retirement, then Mr. A, how can he retire? Then Mr. A has to give a notice in a writing for a period not less than 30 days, specifying his intention to resign as a partner from ABC Creative LLP. Next, a person shall cease to be a partner. This is the automatic cessation. Person shall cease to be a partner in a LLP on his death or a dissolution of LLP. If there is a death of any partner, then he is automatically cease to be a partner in LLP. If there is a dissolution of a LLP, then all the partners cease to be a partner of the LLP. If any person is declared as an unsound minded by the competent court, then he shall be cease to be a partner of the LLP. If any person has applied to be adjudicated as an insolvent, or if any person is declared as an insolvent, then he shall cease to be a partner of the LLP. This criteria B and C is also given under Section 5 of the LLP Act 2008, which shall talk about that if any person is of an unsound mind or an insolvent, then he cannot become a partner in the LLP. If any of the above criteria comes, then the partner will automatically cease to be a partner in the LLP. That means death, dissolution, unsound mind or insolvency. If any of the criteria comes under the picture, then such partner will become automatically cease to be a partner in the LLP. If any person ceases to be a partner in the LLP, here we can call him as a former partner, then such person will be treated as a partner of LLP unless the person has noticed that the former partner has ceased to be a partner of the LLP. Same for example, if ABC Creative LLP, from it Mr. A ceased to be a partner, but LLP is doing deal with the PQR Limited, then Mr. A will be treated as a partner if PQR Limited has not given the notice regarding the cessation of a Mr. A as a partner. So, if the person who is dealing with the LLP has not been given any notice regarding the former partner retirement, then he will be treated as a partner of the LLP. Or, next is, notice that the former partner has ceased to be a partner of LLP has been delivered to the registrar. So, if the person who are dealing with the LLP had to be given notice about cessation of the partner, or such notice about cessation to be filed with the registrar. If any of the condition is fulfilled, then the retired partner will not be considered as a partner of the LLP. But however, both condition is not fulfilled, that is the person who is given or who is dealing with the LLP is not given the notice, or such notice is also not filed with the registrar, thus both condition is not fulfilled, then such retired partner will be treated as the partner of the LLP. Next, the cessation of a partner of LLP does not by itself discharge from a partner from any obligation to the LLP or to other partner or to any other person which he has incurred while being the partner. Same for example, if a Mr. A resigned from ABC Infra LLP as on 21st June 2020, then any act done before 21st June 2020 which create obligation to LLP or to other partner of the LLP, then Mr. A is still liable for such act even after cessation as a partner. So, if any liability or a obligation is incurred before retirement or cessation, then such retired partner is still liable for such LLP. When a partner ceases to be a partner, unless otherwise provided in LLP agreement, such partner will be entitled his share or any nominee of a such partner in the case of a death or a insolvency entitled his share, that is an amount equal to the actual contribution made to the LLP, that is the capital contribution made to the LLP, as well as the his right of share in the accumulated profit after deduction of the loss to the LLP. So, the retired partner or a nominee of a such partner is entitled actual contribution made to the capital contribution made to the LLP or his share of a profit after deducting the loss. For example, Mr. A retire from ABC Infra LLP, the share of Mr. A is 33%. Capital contribution is 1 lakh, contribution of A is 33,000. Further, the accumulated profit as on the date of cessation is 6 lakh. Mr. A entitled from, what is the amount Mr. A entitled from LLP on the date of cessation? Mr. A will get the actual capital contribution, that is 33,000. That is next. Mr. A will get accumulated profit, that is his share, 6 lakh multiplied by 33%, that is 1,98,000. So the total amount Mr. A will get 1,98,000, that is profit share plus actual capital contribution 33,000. So total amount will be 2,31,000. However, such former partner will not be entitled or shall not have any right to interfere the management of the LLP as and when he retire from the LLP. So, he does not have any right to interfere with the management of the LLP. Next, registration of changes in a partner in LLP at per section 25. If there is any change in the partner's information, then partner is required to inform to the LLP. If partner not informed to the LLP, that is he contravenes this provision, then such partner will be punishable with a fine less than, which is not less than 20,000, but may extend to 25,000. If a LLP, after information received from the partner, LLP is required to inform to the register within 30 days of a changes. That is, any change in the name or address of the partner's file or any person become partner or any person cease to be partner, such information is required to be filed to the register within 30 days of such changes. If LLP contravenes this provision, then LLP and every designated partner shall be punishable with a fine which not be less than 2,000, but it may extend to 25,000. Here you must understand LLP and every designated partner. So both will be punishable. A notice must be filed with the register in the prescribed form along with the prescribed fee. It shall be signed by the designated partner and it shall be authenticated. If the form or changes is related to the incoming partner, then the statement is also required to be filed and consent from the new partner is required to be obtained and signed by and authenticated in the manner as may be prescribed. If any person want to seek to be a partner, then he can himself give the notice to the registrar if he have a reasonable cause that LLP will not give the notice to the registrar. If after receiving the notice by registrar, the registrar will give the notice to the LLP that to ask the confirmation about the cessation of a such partner. If no confirmation is received by registrar within 15 days from the communication made by the registrar, then registrar shall register such notice made by the person regarding the cessation of a partner under this section. If Mr. Z want to resign from XYZ LLP, then if Mr. Z has a reasonable clause that XYZ LLP will not file notice to the registrar. Remember that if the notice to the registrar is not filed, then Mr. Z will still be treated as a partner of LLP if LLP is doing or dealing with any other party and such party is not given the notice regarding that Mr. Z is retired. So, if Mr. Z has a reasonable cause that XYZ LLP will not file the notice to the registrar, then Mr. Z will give directly notice to the registrar and registrar shall obtain the confirmation regarding such notice of Z from the LLP. So, after receiving the notice by the registrar, registrar shall ask the confirmation from the LLP. If the LLP does not give the confirmation within 15 days, then registrar shall accept the notice given by Mr. Z. So, Mr. Z will retire if within 15 days no confirmation is received from LLP by the registrar, then registrar will automatically register such notice given by Mr. Z. So, this is the discussion for Section 22 to Section 25 of the LLP Act 2008. Thank you.